Accuplacer prep for radicals. We're going to look at four major issues. We're going to talk about reducing radicals. We're going to talk about adding and subtracting radicals. Multiplying and dividing. Okay, let's first talk about adding and subtracting of radicals. Think of adding and subtracting radicals as something as basic as this. 3x plus 2y. Now you're looking at that like, okay, I can't add that. And why is that? Because they don't have the same variables. Well, to be able to add and subtract a radical, the radical itself must be the same. So if I have this, I can't add it. I can't go 5 plus 3 is 8. No radical. That's it. No further. However, if I had this, now I can say, hey, look, I've got something that's the same. The radical 2's, both I have it, so I'm going to look at it. I'm going to look at the front numbers, or the coefficients, and go 5 plus 3 is 8. And guess what? The radical 2 is handled as if it's just a label. This is how we add. To be able to add radicals, the radicals themselves must be the same. Well, it's the same with subtracting. The first thing you look at is make sure the radicals are the same. If the radicals are the same, then the numbers in front do the subtraction. I see 5 minus 3 equals 2. My label carries. Okay. Adding, subtracting radicals. Next thing we're going to look at, Next thing we're going to look at is multiplying radicals. Unlike adding and subtracting, the radicals do not need to be the same. All we care about is that they're both square roots or they're both cube roots. This is both a square root. That means I can actually rewrite this as this. Well, what is 2 times 3? It's 6. So radical 2 times radical 3 equals radical 6. The numbers inside actually do the multiplication. They do not need to be the same. Do it again. My radicals are the same. So 3 times 5 is 15. So I see a radical 15. Multiplying radicals. Alright, looking back at the list, we still need to talk about dividing. So when we talk dividing, I want you to think fractions. This would be a fraction underneath the radical. And we can't have that. So what are we going to do? We have to break it apart. So I write as radical 3 over radical 5. I am now dividing by a radical. Problem is, I can't divide by something that's not exact. I can't have a fraction with an irrational or a number that's not like a whole number or like 1/2 equals 0.5. That's a solid number. Radicals are not because they don't stop. We can round them, but that's an approximation. They have to be exact. So how do I get rid of a radical in the bottom of a fraction? Well, how do I get rid of anything off the bottom of a fraction is I do it by multiplying by it. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to multiply both the top and the bottom by the bottom. Now, we just learned that when we're multiplying radicals, we multiply the numbers inside the radicals. So 3 times 5 is actually 15, but it's radical 15. And 5 times 5 is 25, so I get a radical 25. Now, hold on here. Isn't 25 a perfect square? I can square root that, right? Yeah, I can. It's a 5. Square root of 25 is 5. 15, not a perfect square, stays the same. Now, be careful. I've watched many students look at that 15 over 5 and say, hey, that reduces to 3. No, this doesn't reduce because radical 15 is being blocked. It's inside its little house, and you can't reduce something that's inside from something sitting outside. Non-mathematical terms there for you. Real quick explanation on dividing. Let's talk the last one, and that's the biggie, and that's reducing. Now, reducing can be done in two methods. The first method is done by prime factorization. That means I'm going to take the number inside, and I'm going to reduce it to all its prime factors. Well, 50 is same as 2 times 25, and 25 is the same as 5 times 5. The 2, 5, and 5 are all prime factors of 50. Looking at this, I look for pairs. If I have a pair of a number, that means I have something I can factor out. And looky there, I have a pair of 5s. So that means a 5 comes out. Not two of them, one of them. So 1 comes out. What's left behind, not circled, is what's left behind in. So 50, square root of 50, is the same, reduced, as 5 radical 2. Let me do one more, because some people never seen the prime factorization method, so let's look at it. I take the square root of 98. I pull the 98 out, and I break it into its prime factorization. And I see 2 times 49. 49 breaks into 7 and 7. Same thing, I look for pairs. I see two pair of 7s, that means a 7 comes out, singular. What's left behind is the 2. So radical 98 reduces to 7 radical 2. That's method 1. Method 2. Method 2, we look at perfect squares. And what is a perfect square? Well, you see me starting to write them. I start thinking 2 times 2 is 4. 3 times 3 is 9. 4 times 4 is 16. 5 times 5 is 25. These are perfect squares. How do I get them? I take a number and I times it by itself. So I could say 6 squared is what? 36. 36 is a perfect square. 7 squared is 49, another perfect square. The list goes on forever. So the second method focuses on perfect squares and factors. So think back to how you learned to factor. You took the tail and you ran the factors of the number. We did the same thing. Run the factors of 72. I see 1 times 72, 2 times 36, 3 times 24, 4 times 18, 5, nope, 6 times 12, 7, nope, doesn't go into 72, 8, yeah, 8 times 9. I know I have all the factors. I go through the list of factors and I look for these numbers. Well, there, 2 times 36, he has a perfect square. 3 times 24, no. 4 times 18, well, 18 is not a perfect square, but the 4 sure is. It's right there. 6 and 12, not on the list. 8 and 9, yep. So I've waited it out. And the thing is, I'm going to look for the largest perfect square. And my largest perfect square is right there, is 36. So that means I can rewrite 72 as the same as 2 times 36. This is me breaking 72 into its perfect squares. Now I look at this, can I square root 2? No. But can I square root 36? I sure can, because if I took square root of 36, guess what? I'm going to get 6. So the final reduced answer, radical 72, is the same as 6 radical 2. All right. Two methods for how to handle radicals on reducing. We talked a little bit about adding, subtracting, multiplying, dividing. There are worksheets to supplement this if you need practice. Good luck with Accuplacer.